Okay, welcome all of you. Today we'll see the simultaneous equations and some illustrations discussing the concept of simultaneous equation. Let us see the first problem. Ram is younger than Mohan by 8 years. If their ages are in the ratio 7:11, find the age of Ram. Now normally what we'll do, the ages of Ram and Mohan, as they are in the ratio 7:11, let's consider the age of Ram is 7a. A is some constant of proportionality. So 7a is the age of Ram, 11a is the age of Mohan. And second, this is the first equation. This will be equation number 1. And Ram is younger than Mohan by 8 years. So Ram is equal to Mohan's age minus 8. So this has become equation number 2. So we have equation number 1. I'll just check with another pen. Yes. We have equation number 1, 7a is to 11a. And next equation is R is equal to M minus 8. Now with these two ratios, what we do, we will try to go for substituting the value. Now R is 7a is equal to M is 11a minus 8. Moment we get this two relationship converted to one relationship, one equation. Now we can solve it. I'll bring 8 on this side and 7 on this side. I'll get 4a, and therefore a is equal to 2. The moment I get a is equal to 2, I'll substitute the value of a is equal to 2 here. 7 into 2, I'll get 14. 11 into 2, I'll get 22. Look here. Ram is of 14 years of age, Mohan is of 22 years of age, their ages are in ratio 7:11, and difference in their age is 8 years. So this is the answer. Let's see the next numerical. Read the numerical carefully. The solution part, see the solution part. Yes, solution is illustrating everything what I have described on the board. You can carefully go through it and now go for the next. Read the problem carefully and try to formulate the simultaneous equations so that we can solve it. If workers Raju and Prakash are paid a total of ₹36,000 per month by their employer, if Raju is paid 80% of the sum paid to Prakash, how much is Prakash is paid per month? Now look here, the salaries of Raju, Prakash. Let the salary be R, let the salary be P. Now Raju is paid 80% of the sum to Prakash. So Raju is equal to, the salary of the Raju is equal to 80% of Prakash is equal to 0.8 Prakash. Now this becomes equation 1. Further, it is given that salary of Raju plus salary of Prakash is equal to 36,000 per month. This has become equation 2. The moment we are able to generate two equations, these are two simultaneous equations, and we can simply solve them to get the answer. Put the value of R over here. 0.8P, R is 0.8P plus P is equal to 36,000. And therefore 1.8p is equal to 36,000, and therefore p is equal to 36,000 upon 1.8 and is equal to, you'll get 20,000. So Prakash's salary is 20,000 and Raju's salary will be 80% of that. So 80% of 20,000 is 16,000. So Raju gets 16,000, Prakash gets 20,000. 16 plus 20,000 is 36,000, and 16,000 is 80% of 20,000. So both the conditions are satisfied. Check the answer in the solution. Check the answer in the solution. Yes, the solution is illustrated. You can go through it casually. And now we move to the next problem. Vivek started a business with rupees 80,000. Now this is a different problem. Carefully read the problem. And now we will discuss the solution. You try to formulate the problem and then we'll go for a solution. Vivek started a business with rupees 80,000. After some time, Pratik joined him with a sum of 4 lakh rupees. At the end of the 10 months, the profit are shared between Vivek and Pratik in the ratio 1:2. Now, we'll find that as investment amount increases, profit increases. As investment duration increases, profit increases. Like suppose I invest it for 1 year and somebody invests for 2 years, naturally he is entitled for double the profit. If I invested 2 lakhs and somebody invests 5 lakhs, he is entitled proportionately higher. So the profit, I can say that profit is proportional to investment amount into investment duration, amount and duration. Now naturally profit will be shared in that way. Now what about Vivek? Vivek is, how much investment Vivek is having? Vivek is having 80,000 investment and that is for 10 months. This is rupee, this is months. So rupee into month is amount into duration. So profit will be proportional to this figure. And now Pratik is in ratio 1:4. How many months Pratik was in business? We don't know. Let's consider M. So we say that Pratik was in business 4 lakhs for M months. 80,000 for 10 months. And Pratik 4 lakh for M month. Okay. And now profit is proportional to this figure, investment into duration of investment. And therefore, profit of Vivek to Pratik, profit of Vivek upon profit of Pratik. Naturally, it is proportional to 80,000 into 10 upon 4 lakh into M. Profit of Vivek, profit of Pratik. But it is given that it is in the ratio 1:4. It is in the ratio 1:4. Now simply take this equation. Only one unknown is there. Simplify it. 80,000 get cut down with 4 lakh. I'll get 10 upon 5M. 4 lakh. We'll get this is equal to 1 by 4. And therefore, we can say that 10 by 5 is 2. 2 by M is equal to 1 by 4 and therefore 8 is equal to M. That means Pratik is going for investment. Pratik is going for investment how much? 8 months. 8 months, 4 lakh. And 10 months, 80,000. Though he is going for 10 months, amount is 1/5 and therefore his share will be very low. Let's see the solution part of it. See the solution carefully and we move to the next problem. Two pipes A and B can fill a tank in 15 and 20 minutes. Read it carefully. If both pipes are used together, how long will it take them to fill the tank? Now, look here. Suppose capacity of tank is L liters. So A goes for L liter in 15 minutes. This is liter. B goes for L liters in 20 minutes. L liter 15 minutes, L liter 20 minutes. If both the pipes are used together, how long it will take? So if both the pipes are there, how long it will take? We don't know. So L liters in T minutes. And our aim is to find out the value of T. Now put it here. A is what? L by 15, B is what? L by 20 and this is L by T. L will get cancelled down on all sides.
we'll get 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20 is equal to 1 by t. LCM of 15 and 20 will be 60. Multiply by 60 here, I'll get here 4 by 60 plus 3 by 60 is equal to 60 by t. We have multiplied the entire equation by 60, which is LCM of 15 and 20, and we get this. Okay, so I'll not multiply here by 60 here. Next step I'll multiply, not in this step. Here it is 1 by t. Now here I'll get 60 LCM, 4 plus 3, 7. So 1 by t is 60 by 7. So 7 by 60. So t will be 60 by 7. Check the solution part of it. Perhaps this is the last one. Let us check. Okay, last problem is a milk vendor has 2 cans of milk. The can A contains 70% of milk. Read the problem carefully and we will see how to go about handling the solution. Milk and water. Milk, water. Can A. Can A contains 70% of milk and remaining is water. So here 70%, 30%. Can B contains 60% of milk and remaining water. Can B contains 60% of milk and remaining 40% of the water. How many liters of milk he should take from each can? We do not know. Say, let him take A liters from this can and B liter from this can. So that we should get 63, this is the total mixture C, 63% of milk and 37% of water. Now what it contains? It contains A liters from A and B liters from B. This is the joint one, A plus B, okay? This is what we want. Now, we realize that, how much is milk in this? We can always say 70% of A is milk, 30% of A is water. 60% of B is milk, 40% of B is water. Now, here this total is how much? A plus B. A plus B is the mixture. So, total is A plus B. So, what I can say that this will be 63% of A plus B. This is 37% of A plus B. Whatever liquid is there, percentage will be like this. And therefore, we realize milk and milk together, this is the milk. Milk and water together, this is the water. Okay, let's see the solution part. You will realize that A plus B is 15, is equation number 1. Equation number 2 is A is equal to 0.7A plus 0.3A. One is milk, other is water. B is equal to 0.6B and 0.4B. 0.6B is milk, 0.4B is water. Resultant mixture has 63% of milk and 37% of water. Naturally, it is of the total, and the total is given as, the C value is given as 15 liters. So we'll say 15 liters, 63% of 15 liter, we'll get equation number 4 and equation number 5. Let's see. Okay, now this one. Equating the equation number 4 and 5 we got, and now we want to eliminate B. Equation 4 is having coefficient of B as 0.6, while equation 5 is having 0.4. So we multiply equation 4 by 2 and equation 5 by 3, so that their coefficients become 1.2, 1.2 each. And then we subtract one equation from the other and we get the value of A. Substitute this value of A into any one of the equation, we get the value of B. Thus, we are able to solve the Samuel's equation. Thank you.